Hi folks, Codetutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. Welcome to the another video on Jetpack Compose. In this video, we will actually start writing simple Android application using Jetpack Compose. And as we start writing our code, we will learn on the go. So let me open Android Studio and let me create a project. And when you start creating a new project, you will see various options here, but the one that you have to choose is this one, which is empty activity with Jetpack Compose. If you don't do this, then later you will have to go to the build.gradle file and have to start adding dependencies. To avoid that step, you can directly choose this and start building the activity from scratch using the Jetpack Compose. So let's select that and let me write sample Jetpack Compose app, JPC app, and let's finish. And that will basically take some time for the Android Studio to create a basic template of the application. So if you see here, this is your main activity and it contains some code. More than that, what I am interested in is knowing build Gradle file contents. And if you come here, you will see that it already contains a lot of Compose related dependencies. That is the advantage of starting with the empty activity with the Jetpack Compose step. If you had not done that, you would not have seen these some of the dependencies that are associated with the Jetpack Compose. So since it is already there, we will get started. So what do we have here? We have a main activity, and then you have a package called as UI.theme, and then there is color.kt, theme.kt, and type.kt. In the previous video, we quickly went through what those three files mean. It's basically about custom theming the application. So this main activity, it extends component activity. And if you see here where this component activity is coming from, it is coming from activity component activity. This is not your app compat activity that you might have seen in your earlier Android development phase. This is compatible with Compose. And then usual stuff, you have onCreate function, and under that you call the super onCreate, and then you have set content. And then under that you have this theme and surface. So right now it contains some default code. So let me just remove this everything and keep it completely empty. And if I try to run this, this is what our application looks like. It doesn't contain anything. So let's start building. I want to simply add text hello world and render it. So what I will do is, to get started, I will have to write a composable. And what is a composable? It is a function. This text view, that is hello world, I want to put it in a screen. So our screen is also a composable. So you can say main screen, and under that main screen, I want to add a text, and the text contains hello world. Or let me rewrite it, hello Jetpack Compose. And now add this in the set content. And if I run this, you will see that hello Jetpack Compose, the text that I have written here. And if you are wondering, what is this text? It is also a composable. And you can see that you can pass lot of various attributes. Right now we are only passing text here, but you can pass text modifier, color, font size, font style, font weight, font family, lot of different things to basically change default look and view of this particular text. We will learn all those things a bit later in the upcoming videos, but let's go back here. And now let me, instead of a text here, let me add a button. And on click, I have to pass a lambda here, but right now I don't want to keep it very complicated. Let me make it very simple. So what I will do is, whenever somebody clicks on it, I want to log something. So main screen is the tag, and then under that you have text, and whatever that you want to give the text for that particular button, that is say click me. And once again, to be able to see this, I should once again run this, and then only I will see this particular button. And then if you go to the logcat, you should be able to get the logs. So this is not surprising at all. But the problem is, every time I am modifying the UI, I will have to run this, and that is very clumsy. If there was a way wherein I could immediately see what the UI looks like without being forced to run the application again and again. That is much better. And we can do that. So let me stop this particular application and hide this. Instead of that, there is this option called as split code and design. So right now you can see that using the compose preview, you can see the design, how to add the compose preview. So let me do that. Preview, show background boolean true. Once again, I will write the annotation composable, and under that, since composable is a function, let me call it as preview. Most of the times we call it as default preview. This is just a naming convention. You can call it whatever that you want. And under that, I can basically call the same code that I have called in the set content. And if I do that, now what you are seeing here is preview of this particular UI. And this doesn't look very pretty. For example, if I add another button here, I don't see two buttons. Let me run this, and you can see that these buttons are not there. It looks like as if there is only one button. The reason why this is happening is these buttons are on one top of one another. So let me just go back here. Instead of having click me, let me call it as click me one and click me two. So you can clearly see that the one that you are seeing here in the preview is click me two. So this one is on top of button one. So how do we improve it? And that we shall see in the next video. Brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video, and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.